in which core is manufactured using polymethyl methacrylate and or perfluorinated polymer PMMA, POFR, PFP, POF. Okay. Next, we start a new concept here that is about related to the fiber materials. Okay. So now we come to another concept called as signal loss or signal distortion in optical fibers. Signal loss or signal distortion in optical fibers. Signal distortion means nothing but signal loss only. Power loss or signal loss only. Okay. So why the signal loss occurs in an optical fiber? Okay, there are some reasons. Okay. For example, it may be due to attenuation. It may be due to bending of the optical fiber. Okay, generally signal loss occurs due to attenuation or due to bending of the optical fiber. Okay, so generally signal loss or power loss occurs due to these kind of reasons. But there is one more reason called as signal dispersion. In the previous class where we have discussed single mode optical fiber and multi mode optical fiber characteristics, if you see the single mode fiber characteristics, there is no dispersion at all. In multi mode fiber, dispersion is very high. What is dispersion? We have discussed in that class. Dispersion means spreading of the light or broadening of the optical pulses inside the optical fiber. What happens when the optical pulses are broadened or spreaded? Generally, it overlaps. One light when spreaded or when broadened overlaps with another light pulse. Okay, so what happens at the receiver? What happens when they travel with the same dispersion and with the same spreading, okay, throughout the optical fiber cable at the receiver, what happens? There will be some errors at the receiver due to the overlap on the neighbor optical rays. Okay, this doesn't come under attenuation and bending loss, but this is also treated as loss only. Signal dispersion is also, because if we are not able to retrieve or detect the actual information from the light at the receiver, so we can call it as a loss. Okay, this dispersion also we can call it as a loss only. So optical loss is due to attenuation or bending of the attenuation in the optical fiber or bending of the optical fiber, physically bending of the optical fiber. Okay, or it is also due to signal dispersion. Signal dispersion means broadening of the light from and overlapping on another light. Okay, which leads to certain errors at the receiver with which actual information cannot be detected or retrieved at the receiver. See the attenuation. First one is attenuation. See the attenuation means loss of light power over the length of the fiber. Very simple. Attenuation means here loss of light power over the length of the fiber. This attenuation may be due to absorption, scattering and radiation effects. Okay, this attenuation loss may be due to absorption. Maybe there are certain reasons here. It may be due to absorption, or it may be due to scattering, or it may be due to radiation effects. Okay, so what is absorption? Absorption is related to fiber material. Absorption loss is related to fiber material. Scattering loss is related to both fiber material and structural imperfections. Scattering loss is related to both fiber material and structural imperfections. And the next one is radiation effects is due to perturbations of the physical structure of the waveguide or optical fiber. Perturbation means disturbance. disturbance of the fiber geometry, or physically if there is some disturbance in the optical fiber, we call the light will get out of the core, so we call it as radiative radiation effects. Okay, so see this once again. Attenuation means loss of light power over the length of the cable or length of the optical fiber. Okay, it may be due to absorption, or it may be due to scattering, or some radiative effects. If it is absorption, generally absorption loss is related to fiber. Later we will discuss what is absorption. Absorption is related to fiber materials. Scattering is related to both fiber materials as well as structural imperfections. Okay. Radiation effects is due to perturbations of the fiber geometry or optical physically some disturbances are there. Okay. Then radiation effects will be there. Okay. See the attenuation. So as I said, attenuation means loss of light power. In detail, we are trying to give the correct definition for attenuation now. Attenuation means loss of light power exponentially over the length of the cable. Exponentially over the length of the cable. General expression is alpha dB. Attenuation formula is alpha in decibels is 10 log Pin by P out, where Pin is the optical power launched at the launching end. Okay, input power launched at the fiber or at the launching end of the optical fiber. P out is the output power at the receiver. Output power at the receiver. But in case of ideal fiber, we are taking one more condition here. In case of ideal fiber, generally Pin will be equal to P out. Ideal fiber means there is no loss. So input power, whatever the output power received, it is equal to the input power launched at the launching end. So what happens then? Both are same means P in equal to P out means alpha dB attenuation is equal to zero. Okay. The same attenuation per kilometer is rewritten as 4.343 into alpha P, where alpha P is the fiber attenuation coefficient. Okay, so we define here attenuation means loss of light power exponentially or decrease of light power exponentially over the length of the fiber. It is given as alpha equal to 10 log P in by P out, where P in is the amount of power at the launching end, input power at the launching end. What is P out? Output power at the receiver. If it is the optical fiber cable is an ideal fiber, there will be no loss. Then P in will be equal to P out. So there is no loss, there is no attenuation, zero. Okay, the same attenuation per kilometer you can calculate like 4.3 into 4.343 into alpha P. That is nothing but alpha P is the fiber attenuation coefficient in terms of kilometer inverse. So next one is in attenuation, as I said, attenuation may be due to absorption or scattering, okay, or radiation. So absorption. What is absorption loss? Absorption means it is due to the dissipation of optical power in the form of heat energy. The loss of optical power in the optical fiber cable in the form of heat energy. Okay, so such kind of loss is called as absorption loss. Such kind of loss is called as absorption loss. Generally, this absorption loss is caused, okay, either due to atomic defects in the glass, or intrinsic absorption, or due to extrinsic absorption. Absorption loss means loss of light power in terms of or in the form of heat is called absorption loss. It may be due to atomic defects in the glass, or due to intrinsic absorption, or due to extrinsic absorption. Now let us see, what is atomic defect? Okay, so atomic defect means if there are certain molecules missing in the fiber material due to fabrication defects. Okay, due to fabrication defects, if some molecules are missing or some high density molecules are present, okay, that leads to that they are called as atomic defects. Such kind of defects, fabrication defects are called as atomic defects. Atomic defects means imperfections in the atomic structure of the fiber material. Means some atoms are missing or some high density atoms are added, whatever it may be, they are called as atomic defects. Okay, then what is intrinsic absorption? When the material is absolutely in pure state, no material, other material is added. For example, as I said, in the glass fiber, if you see, it is manufactured using SiO2 only. SiO2 only. Okay. So for SiO2, what we are doing? We are adding certain elements. Some oxides we are adding. Some sulfides we are adding. Okay. To change the refractive index. To increase or decrease the refractive index of core and clad. Okay. We are adding some other materials. If you don't add, if no material is added, okay, then also power loss may occur. Such kind of loss is called intrinsic absorption loss. So it occurs when the material is absolutely in pure state, no variations in the density or refractive index. Okay. Next one is extrinsic absorption. It occurs when some metals like iron, chromium, cobalt, copper, heavy metals. When some heavy metals, unwanted heavy metals are added during fabrication process, leads to the change of refractive index completely, okay, which are not required actually, which are not to be happened, due to which unwanted addition of certain higher heavy metals like iron, chromium, cobalt, copper, etc. Okay, due to addition of this, unwanted addition of this leads to the power loss in the form of heat, and it is called extrinsic absorption. Once again, see here, absorption loss is due to atomic defects or intrinsic absorption or extrinsic absorption. Atomic defects means by fabricating, if some molecules are missing or if higher density molecules are added, okay, the atomic structure of the fiber material will change. Due to that, optical power loss may occur in the form of heat, and it is called as absorption loss due to atomic defects. The second one is intrinsic absorption, which occurs when the material is absolutely free, which is not actually required. Because certain sulfides, certain oxides are generally added to the SiO2, which is mandatory for glass fibers. But if they are not added or if those molecules are missing, we call it as intrinsic absorption, due to which generally the power loss may occur in the form of heat. The next one is unwanted addition of certain heavy metals like iron, chromium, cobalt, copper, etc. may also lead to power loss in the form of heat, and it is called extrinsic absorption. Next one is scattering loss. If you see the scattering loss, it is generally that loss is due to variation in the material density. Okay, it happens from the compositional fluctuations. Like, for example, see, glass is, we all know, glass is made up of SiO2 or GeO2 or P2O5 composition. That we know already, that we have discussed in the glass fibers. Okay, if that composition is not fixed, okay, if the composition is varied, unwanted variation of the compositions leads to scattering loss. The scattering loss is given by the simple relation alpha equal to 8 pi cube by 3 lambda power 4 n1 n square minus 1 whole square kb tf beta t. This is the relation to find the scattering loss of the optical fiber, where kb means Boltzmann constant, TM means temperature at which these fluctuations, compositional fluctuations are happening. Next, beta T means compressibility of the material. Okay. So when these three factors are known, we can find the what is the amount of scattering loss that may occur inside the optical fiber. Next one is bending loss. Bending loss is a loss that occurred due to the imperfection of the physical variation of the optical fiber. Okay, for example, say this is the optical fiber. Okay, so there is a bend here. So the light should internally reflection should be like this. But here at the bending, due to this imperfection of the structure, due to this bending, the light may go, it should come here, but it is going outside the fiber. At the bend, there is a bending here. These kind of losses are called as bending losses. Bending loss of the optical fiber may cause mechanical failure or radiative loss. So till now what we have studied in the unit 2, we have started the unit 2. What we have studied now? We have studied the unit 2. We started with the fiber materials. Requirements in selecting the fiber materials, three requirements are there. The first one is it must be possible. The material should be thin, it should be long, okay, and it should be flexible, okay, it should not be rigid, it should be flexible. Next one, the material must be transparent, it should guide the light for longer distances. The next one is these materials should have slight refractive index variations. Okay, so based upon these requirements, there are certain fibers made up of certain materials. For example, glass fibers are there, which are generally made up of SiO2, as well as they are mixed with B2O3, GuO2 or phosphorus pentoxide P2O5. Okay, so that the refractive variation in the refractive index can be achieved. See the combination of the core and cladding. If you see in core as well as clad, the common material is SiO2 here. Okay, but to increase the refractive index of the core, we are making a mixture GuO2 plus SiO2. Okay, to increase the refractive index, but in such case the clad should be SiO2 only, manufactured with SiO2 only. So like that, the composition should be made without any errors. Next, halide glass fibers. In long distance communication, generally transmission losses occur. So low transmission losses are generally required in long distance communications. In such cases, optical fibers made up of 7th group elements. Okay, made up of 7th group elements, which are called as halide glass fibers, are preferred. Next one is active glass fibers. Active glass fibers means rare earth metals like cerium, erbonium, etc. are the atomic numbers from 57 to 71. These kind of metals added to the SiO2 which produce active glass fibers, generally used to perform amplification and attenuation. Next, chalcogenide glass fibers. They are generally the chalcogen element like sulfur, selenium, tellurium, added with certain elements like phosphorus, chlorine, bromium, cadmium, etc. Okay, and that mixture is used for the fiber fabrication is called as chalcogenide glass fiber. Generally, optical switches and fiber lasers are generally the applications of chalcogenide glass fibers. Plastic fibers means if the core is manufactured with either polymethyl methacrylate or perfluorinated polymer. So generally these kind of fibers are called as plastic fibers, where high speed services are required. plastic fibers are generally used. Okay, so next concept is signal distortion in optical fiber. Signal distortion means signal loss only. That may be due to attenuation or bending. Okay, signal dispersion leads to some errors at the receiver. Signal dispersion means broadening of the light. Okay, due to which light rays overlap on the neighbor light rays. Okay, which leads to some errors at the receiver. That is also treated as loss only. Okay, so in which attenuation means loss of light power. Okay, so exponentially as the length of the fiber. Okay, so this attenuation may be due to absorption or scattering or radiation effects. Absorption is related to fiber material. Scattering is related to both fiber material as well as structural imperfection. Next, radiation effects means perturbations of the optical fiber. The attenuation is calculated as alpha equal to 10 log Pn by Pout. Pn means the input power launched at the core, starting point of the core. Pout means optical power received at the receiver. All attenuation per kilometer can also be calculated using 4.343 into alpha p, where alpha p is the fiber attenuation coefficient. Next one is absorption loss. Okay, what is absorption loss? Absorption loss belongs to attenuation concept only. Okay, so it is absorption loss means loss of optical power in terms of heat, in the form of heat. Generally it may be due to atomic defects or intrinsic absorption or extrinsic absorption. Atomic defects means are the imperfections in the atomic structure due to missing molecules or adding of high density molecules. Intrinsic absorption means there is no other material added to the silicon dioxide, okay, due to which also power loss may occur. It is called intrinsic absorption. Extrinsic absorption means unwanted addition of certain heavy metals like iron, chromium, cobalt, copper, etc., which also lead to the power loss in the form of heat. Scattering loss means compositional variation. If there is compositional variation in the optical fiber, then the optical power loss occurs, okay, as a scattering loss. That can be calculated as using the formula alpha scattering is equal to 8 pi q by 3 lambda power 4 n square minus 1 whole square k into tf into beta. Bending loss is another loss. It is a physical loss. It is a physical imperfection loss of the optical fiber. Okay, so if there is a bending, physical bend, okay, at the bent curvature, okay, the light may go out of the core. The light may go into the clad. Okay, so if there are 100 bends in the optical fiber, in the long distance, if you see the long distance communication, if there are 100 bends, okay, so at 100 points there is a power loss. So that is called as bending loss. Okay, it is a mechanical failure. It is a mechanical failure. So these are certain concepts we have learned today. Tomorrow's class, in the next class, we'll come with a new interesting concept. Thank you very much.